Welcome back. Now we're going to be looking at the communication pie, the three modes of communication as coined by Albert Morabian in 1981. Now you may have seen this pie chart before, and the reason I felt it essential to put it in this course, not just because it's a communication skills course, but because sometimes this pie chart can be misinterpreted. So looking at the pie chart, we see there's three percentages. It's usually fairly similar depending on which source you're receiving the information from. There could be some slight variations, but generally there's a large part of the pie which is usually between 50 to 60% showing that facial expressions and body language are the main communication delivery mediums when you're communicating with somebody. Then there is usually the smaller part, which here is 38%, which is the tone of your voice and the style of your voice, the emphasis, etc. And then 7%, which is the actual words that we use. Now, the reason that I would like to just point out that this sometimes can be misinterpreted is because this is only correct if there is a mismatch. For example, if you're talking to somebody on the phone, of course, your body language is not going to be 55% of the communication that's going ahead in the interaction, because you're talking on the phone, so that would be nonsense to say anything otherwise. And similarly, you know, in a meeting when you're trying to get points across, if you have information to diverge to the team or to your employees, your staff, your clients, whoever, then the words obviously are of significant importance. So this 7% is only when there is a mismatch. This pie chart as a whole, it should only really be used when there is a mismatch. Say, for example, you are talking to somebody and they say they are feeling absolutely fantastic, but you look at their face and you can see that they're virtually in tears, they're not looking well, they're not looking happy, so their words are completely mismatching what their body and appearance is saying to you, you would go with the body because the 55% would be a larger proportion of truth compared to the 7% that their words are actually giving off. So that's the best way to use this pie chart. The way I like to use it is to show the importance of body language. The main thing is, though, congruency of body language. If you're happy, you smile. We'll be talking about this a little bit later on as well, but your emotions, for example, will influence your behavior, your posture, your body language, your tone also, and vice versa. So just bear that in mind, please, that body language is exceedingly important, followed then by sort of emphasis of voice, of tone and style, and words as well, obviously. But if there is ever a mismatch, people will be looking at your body to determine the true result of what they're going to establish from what you are communicating with them. Anyway, that's it's a fairly useful slide. It's something that I'm sure you will see again. It's pretty common, so I just wanted to explain that to you. See you in the next module.